gentlemen and female gentlemen, it is time for the worst vegan of all time. Now, I am shocked. I saw Sunny V2 drop this video, the vegan TikToker who's worse than vegan teacher, and I will admit, I don't think that that is possible. I think that is cap. I think my man Sunny V2 is capping on God, zero skibbity toilet riz. I just saw this clip of the vegan teacher recently doing some heinous stuff, but this is the 100% blind reaction to a crazy vegan person. As you know, I will absorb all lore, including the lore of crazy vegans. Like, on our podcast, I recently showed the boys a clip of the vegan teacher, and I'm going to show you this clip before we watch the Sunny V2 video, because I do not think that this is going to be beaten.
Oh, no, Jesus. But this is the clip?
Yeah, this is the clip.
About to find out.
But look closely. This meat is covered in barbecue sauce, which is made of salt, sugar, and spices. The baby is enjoying the barbecue sauce, which is vegan.
Uh-huh. Okay, cool, cool.
If this had been a lollipop, the child would have had the same reaction.
All right, what's your point, lady?
If this had been somebody's
crazy
sauce, the child would have had the same reaction.
Bro, this...
Whoa! Dude, yobers!
Psychotic.
It gets worse. It gets worse. It gets worse.
Oh my god.
Picture that.
Picture it, bro.
No.
Feel that in your gut.
No.
No, it's okay.
Right. Let that imagery wash all over your body.
No.
What? Is this a clip from Tipster Stream?
When I saw that the title of this video, all right, this Sunny V2 video, when I saw the title, the vegan TikTok that's worse than vegan teacher, I will admit to you, I am skeptical, okay? I am skeptical. Like, actual... fucking goosebumps when I heard that shit. 500 years dungeon, no trial, for real, for real. Like, holy crap. Anyway, let's see, I'll be surprised. The 100% blind reaction to fucking insane psycho vegan people. This is the new content grind.
Vegan booty is often
vegan booty. Oh god.
Called the vegan teacher's daughter. She thinks walking your dog is animal abuse has been
walking your dog animal abuse. Wait, what? Isn't that the opposite of animal abuse? Oh my god.
Been on the news for calling horses slaves.
Okay, listen, she's fucked up, obviously. Okay, I'm not gonna lie. That's pretty fucked up. But at the same time, like, again, still not worse than vegan teacher. Still not worse than vegan teacher. Oh my god.
And believes it's okay fighting butchers, service workers, and even children at their birthday party.
She fights children? Oh my, this is like Omega Karen. What the fuck? Raid boss Karen entered the fray.
The government has banned her from living in her hometown.
Based government. Rare based government moment.
And her first viral video will start to show you why. The event scene behind her is the Million Paws Walk, where families meet to walk their dogs together and help raise funds for animals in need.
Holy shit, that's the most wholesome thing in the universe. They go to walk dogs for charity to help the animals. That is literally the most wholesome thing in the universe.
Well, Vegan Booty called the event
the most violent thing that you could ever participate in.
Yeah, go tell that to fucking Hitler, okay? Violent, the most violent thing you could participate in? A dog walk for animal charities. Now that's pretty violent. 1v1 me, little shit, you slave-owning little shit. That's what she says to someone who's walking a dog.
Protesting that every animal should be treated the way that dogs are.
Why would you love one but pay for the suffering and abuse of other animals? Pigs.
Why? What? You see, I have an answer to all these questions. I fucking hate when vegans do this and get away with that shit. Now, obviously, not all vegans are this insufferable, but a lot of people this insufferable are vegan. You see, the thing is, dogs are not kosher, and therefore, I don't eat dogs. Cows, kosher. Therefore, I eat cows. If you want to know more about kosher lore, Bloodrunks clipped me on his channel. Look up Nux Explains Kosher Lore and you'll get all the lore there. But you see, the reason is that's why, okay? Dogs, not kosher, don't eat. Cows, kosher, eat. If God is okay with me eating cows, then it's moral, okay? Get out of here.
Are in fact more intelligent.
Why do we eat cows? because they taste fucking good.
Imagine then dogs.
Hypocritically, however, Vegan Booty owned a dog herself, which she tied—
oh my god, this slave-owning piece of shit—
to a leash and used it to pull her while she skated.
Oh my god, she's a slave owner. The way she would make her slaves pull her.
It's pretty funny how you are protesting, yet you have a dog pulling you. Pretty hypocritical, and the hypocrisy didn't stop there.
Oh, good, let's go. Fucking kill her.
Because
bet she doesn't own a cow! Oh, cooked!
Vegan Booty then showed up at a charity football match, disrupting 35,000 spectators because she thought her cause was way more important.
Destroy her. Annihilate her. She's running on the football field? Fucking dogpiler. Let's see what I did there.
Satisfying turn of events, she was fined $1,800 for the
stunt,
This wasn't too expensive for the exposure.
Yeah, she should have at least done it naked. That would have really proved everyone wrong. That would have fucking, like, oh god.
It provided.
Would you do it all again?
Yes. 100%.
She's such an insufferable piece of shit. Oh my god.
However, at around the same time, Isaac Butterfield was going viral for his anti-vegan videos.
Oh my god, people love shitting on vegans. It's so good. Thank you, vegans. Can I just take this moment to thank vegans? Thank vegans for this, the amount of money that they have made so many people.
Featuring Tash in The Worst Vegans on TikTok. Right.
Why is your name Vegan Booty when you run around with that? Change your name to Vegan Pancake Ass.
What? Who is this guy? Who let him cook? Wow! Bro! He destroyed her! Bro!
Let us all get on with our lives.
This guy—
holy shit, he killed her. He killed her.
Gave Tash a chance to respond, although she was—
eat pussy, not animals.
That is the worst fucking shit I've ever seen.
What on earth? That is the worst shirt ever.
With a brutal dislike ratio, as Isaac's audience offered their very first downvote. He'd therefore
this is classic Sunny V2. This is the most Sunny V2 shit in the world.
As Isaac—
right, she got destroyed, right?
Isaac's audience offered their—
I have never disliked a video in my life. From Nate Lawden 7884 4 years ago with 8 likes on it. And people in her audience never disliked a video before in their life.
Very first downvote.
Bro, that's fucking hilarious that he included that in the video.
He'd therefore slam Vegan Booty again.
Meet some—
yo, he keeps going. See, that's the thing. That's the beauty of YouTube. This is why I fucking love YouTube.
Their very first downvote. Right. He'd therefore slam—
all right. So she called out Isaac Butterfield, okay? She made a video, 8,000 views.
And Vegan Booty—
he made a video, 800,000 views, 100x ratio. Bro, see, dude, this is what I love so much about YouTube, all right? So, like, Boogie2988, he'll do some heinous shit, right? He'll get, like, 10,000 views, right? And then Moist Critical will just drop a video, huge Boogie video, 16 hours ago, 2.5 million views. It's like, dude, this is— they are not the same! They are not the same! It's like, bro, you got annihilated. You are giving your haters so much money. Like, it's just, it's beautiful. All right.
Again.
Meat's amazing, it's delicious, and guess what, bitch? I'm gonna have a big dirty steak for dinner. I hope you enjoy your broccoli, you tiny little child.
Yeah,
destroyed. Yeah, no, see, the reason why I ate meat is because it is, in fact, yummy. But my favorite thing is, you know, in the honor of all the vegan, this vegan fat ass, whatever, vegan flat ass, what is that her name? Whatever she said, in her honor, I will have meat today. I will, because of you. I wasn't going to, but now I will.
With comments such as—
so you are personally causing more meat to be eaten.
Who else came from Isaac's channel?
I will eat twice as much in your honor.
This was only helping Vegan Booty grow. She'd use her new—
bro, what was that shit?
From Isaac's channel. This was only helping—
end the animal holocaust. Holy fuck, how do you even say shit like this?
Vegan Booty grow. She'd use her newly found fame to launch a vegan clothing company, spoofing the anti-social social club to instead read anti-animal cruelty club. Well,
that is the worst joke, a play on words I've ever seen in my life.
Isaac then launched his own anti-vegan social club.
That's awesome. That's awesome, dude, troll her. The actual troll. Oh my god.
Leading vegan Booty to call in heavy reinforcement.
That's fucking hilarious, bro.
She discusses Isaac Butterfield's anti-vegan club responsible for this vegan phobia with no
vegan phobia. Stop making phobias sounding so based. Oh my god, bro.
One other than
what are they gonna put? She is one step away from introducing the LGBTV, all right? She is going to add veganism to the LGBT community. I'm telling you, that is coming.
That vegan teacher.
He literally has shirts made that say anti-vegan club.
The
based. Incredibly fucking based. Incredibly based. It's a joke! But also it's so real.
It became so...
See, vegan phobia is real. I, in fact, am scared of vegans. They think that my life is worth as little as the animals that I consume. So that's pretty fucked up.
Close that they
hate me more than I hate them.
Call each other family.
Hi, sweetie.
You see, the thing is, they think I'm a murderer. I just think they're insane. We are not the same. We are literally not the same, okay? They think I am a murderer because I eat cows, all right? I think they're retarded. We are not the same, is what I'm saying.
Hey, how are you?
Hello. Hey, mom.
Oh my god, your friend. Hey, mom. Oh, hey, mom. To the lady that imagining babies sucking on penises.
Mom, how you going?
However, it was obvious vegan Booty was the crazier of the two.
Okay, all right. This I still have to hear. I am, listen, she's crazy. She's absolutely batshit insane. I am here. I am here for that. But holy shit, crazier than the vegan teacher? I am waiting to substantiate those allegations.
She began infiltrating supermarkets wearing an animal onesie.
That's not called infiltrating supermarkets. That's called walking into supermarkets.
Before standing in the milk section, dissuading shoppers from their purchase.
I was violated. They stole my babies and murdered my son so you could have my breast milk. Dude, you didn't have to take it to like a horny place. Holy shit.
Yes. For obvious reasons, staff weren't too happy about this. And even after being ejected, she still yelled outside the store.
Her babies are taken away from her straight after birth and her son is murdered.
As a result, Tash was permanently banned from Australia's two main supermarkets.
Can you imagine being banned from a supermarket? Oh my god, dude, it's crazy.
Yet this didn't stop her protests, as vegan Booty would only get worse.
Bro, what the fuck? Was this edited? Dude, she has fucking Sith eyes.
Yet this didn't stop her protests.
Okay, yeah, I was edited.
As vegan Booty would only get...
I got scared for a second. I was like, holy shit, is she an acolyte of the Sith? But okay.
Worse. She'd shop at McDonald's in a much more detailed costume, being kicked out not by staff, but instead this time police. Hilariously, this guy began his own protest, countering her with a-
Yes! Yes!
A legend-
Based! Yo! I love this guy. This guy's awesome. Be like him. Meat is delicious. Guys, you know what PETA stands for? It stands for people eating tasty animals.
Scary sign. In vegan Booty's next stunt, she walked into KFC and poured orange paint everywhere.
Yeah, that's called vandalism, fucking bitch. Go to jail.
While blasting dying animal noises for over 15 minutes.
Who listens to dying animal noise? She thinks that we are crazy, but she listens to dying animal noise ASMR.
Not gonna lie, but you're incredibly selfish to the people that work at that place. All they're trying to do is do their job.
Good soldiers follow orders.
I feel so sorry for the workers, while even other vegans called vegan Booty out.
She is-
See, there's nothing wrong with being vegan. You could be vegan, okay? It's when that ideology that animal lives are equivalent to human lives takes over that makes you a fucking insane, crazy person and should be diagnosed ASAP.
Giving veganism a bad name.
People wrote about Tasha's public stunts. Instead of promoting vegans, you kind of just embarrassed them, and nothing showed this better than her children's party meltdown.
What the fuck? Children's party? Oh god, she should not be allowed around children.
These two horses were clearly very well looked after and were waiting outside a family festival kids could take a picture.
Oh god, what is she doing? Please have sex with the horse, that would be funny.
Well, of course, vegan Booty somehow thought it was abuse.
Does she really think these horses would be happier in the wild? I mean, they might be, I don't know. But does she really think they will be? These were born and raised like this, to be groomed like this. Like, does that really, Do you think that this horse would do well in the wilderness?
I just want to know who the slave owner is.
Okay.
I want to know who the slave owner is. Holy shit. Like, people just say inflammatory shit for the sake of it, but this is insane.
That's disgusting. This is animal abuse.
Got him! Destroy! Oh my god, she annihilated her!
She tried-
Vegan booty just got destroyed, bro!
I didn't fail to make any-
Your ass hanging out of your shorts!
Decent points.
If you were in their position, would you be happy?
I'm not a horse! Everyone said yes! Dude, you're getting your hair braided for free, looked after, given food, given shelter, given a loving family. Yeah! Yeah! Their position is great! It literally destroyed her. Oh my god. You mean protected from predators and given food and board and a happy life, not having to worry about rent or healthcare? Yeah! That sounds pretty good!
Oh, vegan booty wasn't finished there. She'd then go into the festival to find the horses again, disrupting all photos by making a public announcement.
These innocent beings are no different to our beloved dogs and cats.
They're no different than dogs and cats? How is that an argument? What are they doing?
Look like they're under so much stress.
This awesome dad then quickly stopped their antics.
Not far as my kids, man.
Yeah, I'm not talking about it.
No, we'll just keep walking that way then. Keep walking that way.
And thankfully, police were there to intervene. After posting her...
Dude, they gotta get her fucking on a watch list. They need to put a fucking anklet on her. Like some sort of ball and chain. Like, she should not be allowed in public, disrupting the peace to this extent.
Video to TikTok, Tash again made national news, in which they'd interview the horse's owner.
Meg Freeman owns the pony business. She says she's being bombarded with abuse by vegan protesters. Meg Freeman wants her charged.
They're like terrorists. They're not going to go away.
Okay, dude, that's... Whoa! Dude, everyone's fucking insane. Everyone's crazy. Okay, listen, vegan protesters, they're annoying as fuck. They disturb the peace. They're not terrorists, okay? All right, and listen. Whoa! Oh my god.
Well, only 1 week later, Vegan Booty announced, I'll be going to court on the 13th of May, as I received a summons for a restraining order from the owner of Ponies for All Occasions.
Oh my god, dude.
Who dislike me are triggered because I've made them realize that they're animal abusers.
I'm not actually triggered. I love this lady. Everyone's out here making fun of her, saying that they hate her. I appreciate the content. Listen. I subscribe to the Order of Chaos. Cinch is forever my goat. And I, as a lord of change myself, have to say with all the certainty in the world that brothers get together, get the heavy flamer, purge this heretic. And also, I'm going to be making more money on my video reacting to this than she probably made on her entire channel. So that's a dub.
What I'm going through right now isn't a loss. It only means we're winning.
I'm always a non-violent protester and I never harass anyone.
You do harass people. You are a liar. I love how she says it like she's in an ISIS video. What the fuck? I never harass anyone. I am always a peaceful protester. I am not mentally retarded.
Don't even think the vegan teacher is this crazy. This girl is making vegan teacher seem like an angel.
I don't know. I still, listen, she's fucked up. She's crazy. She does this shit in public. She harasses people and all that. But I still think that the vegan teacher is sitting there, picture a baby sucking on a penis. The vegan teacher going through that, I thought that was insane. Like, insane. I did not have sexual relations with that woman.
At least
with that horse. I did not have sexual relations with that horse. Holy shit, Sneeko really getting... Sneeko's girlfriend going crazy up there. Holy crap. She's on that grind set right now. God damn. Calm down, Sneeko's girlfriend. Calm down. Calm down. Too many people. Too many people. Holy shit. She just got railroaded by like an entire rodeo. Whew.
The vegan teacher didn't have her own number plates, as this made vegan booty foolishly recognizable.
Bro, I hope that she goes to prison and is forced to eat prison food slop that's all made of animals. That would be the most glorious real life of all time.
Meat and cheese smeared across her family's car. Vegan activist Taj Peterson says this cruel joke crosses the line.
People recognized her car, then threw meat bones on her driveway.
Yeah! Honestly based. Fucking based. I know what you're thinking. Two wrongs don't make a right. I disagree. Sometimes people need to be put in their place. I don't see this as a second wrong. This is what they call a based. Sometimes people need a taste of their own medicine.
Yeah. Yet trolls weren't the only people who showed up at her house.
I've woken up once again to the police knocking at my door.
I'm so sorry to hear that, crazy bitch.
So I've been issued with another barring notice.
Wait, so you mean in your place of residence you don't like being harassed? When in your private life you don't like being harassed by people in the public that think that you're a piece of shit for some reason? Is that what you're saying?
Controversial vegan activist is banned from every pub in her state after becoming notorious for wild stunts where she screams at innocent families.
Based. Holy goddamn, Sneeko. Sneeko, get a hold of your girlfriend. Can someone call Sneeko? His girlfriend's going crazy upstairs. All right. I feel like the next guy came. That guy was just a two-pump chump. The third guy in line is going to be coming in soon for another little problem. That's the way I imagine it normally.
Anything that sells alcohol, I'm not allowed into. A penalty of $10,000 applies if I break this barring notice.
The ban had come after another disgusting
Oh, that's the third guy of the train running the train on Sneeko's girl. Holy shit, that guy, he came real quick. Oh my god.
Protest.
Kissing man is 30,000 shots every hour! Animal abusers!
Dude, whenever I see people like this in public, because they do show up, right? When they do show up in public, these crazos, and whenever they do, it just... Oh, God. Dude, Sneeko's girl is having the fucking time of her life out there. But whenever you have someone like this in public, I always look at them like the complete insane humans. God.
Actual
public menace.
Yet vegan booty was still convinced that she'd done nothing wrong.
I don't really have a right to freedom of speech here in Australia.
Based. Remove her right to freedom of speech. Awesome. Hell yeah. That's what I'm saying.
Australia. It's honestly pretty corrupt.
Yeah, dude, Australia is so corrupt for not letting her into pubs. Her literal freedom of speech. Based. Get the fuck out of here. Public menace. Public nuisance. Fuck you, lady. Bye.
If you ask me.
Honestly, I think she deserves the Illyn Payne treatment. I've been doing Game of Thrones lore, and I think pulling her tongue out with hot tweezers sounds like a pretty fucking good solution.
Freedom of speech is just going to a restaurant and screaming like a lunatic about murder.
Yeah, I love the freedom of speech excuse. They're silencing me! Meanwhile, Sneeko's like actually sending people to fucking... to commit a holy war against Jews. That's what Sneeko has been saying, and he's like, and he wonders why he's banned. Wait, he's banned? Why?
There is a difference between speech and screaming. Your freedom of speech, our freedom to eat meat. Goodbye.
She'd therefore leave
Perth and spend a month protesting in Melbourne, but when
Oh my god, it's insane. Bro, she should be on a no-fly list.
She tried to fly back home. The government said she couldn't return.
She was on a no-fly list! Pre-watch the no-fly list allegations. Let's go, baby. Let's go!
The Australian police.
Bro, girl, do you know how many birds die because they get sucked into the engines of planes? I wouldn't use planes if I was you.
Have banned me from entering into my own city.
If it's not your city. You don't own the city. Goodbye. Bye-bye.
Choose to fly home.
Don't be a bitch. Live with the animals. You love them. They have a high society. They're as conscious as humans, right? Go live with the fucking kangaroos.
Could face a 1-year imprisonment.
Her application was rejected based on her statements made in public, and after eventually having the rejection overturned, you will not believe how awful she became.
Bro, she has an OnlyFans? How on earth does someone like this have an OnlyFans? Like, who's gonna get into an emotional relationship, some sort of weird, crazy relationship with her?
She'd go back to harassing the innocent-
Oh my god, she can't stop. The ponies can't give consent, therefore it's forced labor. Ha ha ha! I don't give consent to seeing you in public. Therefore, it is slavery. What is this even? This is so stupid. This is like telling your kids to do their homework or eat their greens or clean the floor. It's like tell your kids to do anything. Kids can't consent and therefore it's forced labor. Yeah. Yeah, okay. And?
Pony business.
You could tell she had no forced labor in her entire life and that's why she ended up such a fucking narcissistic piece of shit.
Before trying to ruin the life of a hard-working chef. John Mountain owns Fire Restaurant in northern Perth, where on one unassuming night, a diner made a complaint about the lack of vegan options on the menu and was charged $32 for vegetables.
I hate this about society, bro. Dude, no one is for- the beauty of the free market is no one is forcing you to buy anything. If you go to a restaurant with expensive food, you could decide to not eat at that restaurant and you can go to a different restaurant. Yeah, sure, it's annoying that it's expensive, but fuck you. They have the right to sell it for however much they want, okay? And if they don't sell vegan shit, and then you don't have to eat their food. You could go somewhere else. No one is forcing you to be here. God, I hate these entitled pieces of shit.
Well,
boss, what if you lived under communism? It's a terrible idea. Communism sucks. That's why it doesn't work. But boss, what about communism? What, you think my morals are dictated by the law? The law is corrupt half the time. I don't agree with every law because it's a law. But one of the good laws is the free market.
Other than bending the knee, John instead stated it is not a vegan restaurant. And if customers want vegan options, they should go elsewhere.
Base, no one's forcing you to be here.
Announcing on their Facebook page, sadly all vegans are now banned from Fire.
Yeah, that's fucked up too. Like, don't. Why should you stop a vegan, okay?
For mental health reasons.
Oh, for mental health reasons. That's crazy. Now listen, he went too hard. He went too hard.
We thank you for your understanding.
All vegans are banned. End of. No more. Never again. God help them.
Everybody loved the chef's bold move.
Vegan free zone. This is crazy.
Well, except for one person known as Vegan Booty.
Oh my fucking god, she's gonna make this man's life miserable for a joke. Blood on your hands! You psychopath! You psychopath! You psychopath!
She showed up at the restaurant not just once,
no,
but
having sex with your dogs like you do is animal abuse. That's not animal abuse.
Twice, blasting dying animal noises even after being ejected. Having disrupted his business multiple times, the chef understandably lost it, yet still took responsibility for
that's fucked up. Like, it's so rough. Like, she obviously riled him up, but still, that doesn't give him the right to attack her, obviously. Dude, it's fucked up. And she's like, it's my freedom of speech, my freedom to ruin your life.
The damage Tash had done.
See, the thing is, I wouldn't eat in this restaurant now. No one wants to eat in a restaurant where you have psycho fuckers standing outside yelling and shit and blasting dying animal noises. No one likes that animals are dying. I just like that meat is tasty. You give me tasty food with fake meat and it's just as tasty and I'll eat the fake meat. But I hate to say it, fake meat tastes like shit. Tofu meat tastes bad. Soy milk doesn't taste as good as regular milk. Like, animal products are just superior.
And I'm sorry to say, Layla, I lost my cool, and I lost my cool because now it's really disrupting my business. And I could see the look on my customers' faces, my staff, they were all a little scared and a bit-
Of course, no one wants this, especially because these people are insane.
Nervous, and I stormed out.
Sadly for Vegan Booty, however, her activism exploded the restaurant's popularity.
Let's go, dude! Oh, I love the Streisand effect so much. I love the Streisand effect. Oh, it's beautiful. Oh my God. Ah, for real, for real.
Yeah. So far as my business is concerned, I've trebled my income. I'm-
Let's go, dude.
Now, in her words, having to murder more animals because of their actions.
Fucking based. That is so fucking awesome. Oh god, this there, that's divine comedy, bro. Divine fucking comedy. Dude, you have any idea how many more animals vegans inspired me to eat over the years? Every time I watch a vegan video, it just makes me want to eat more animals. Dude, vegans are the best advertisement. Dude, this should be like a psyop. Someone with a restaurant needs to hire some crazy vegan psychopath to go outside and start yelling and shit. Oh, dude, that's so smart. Your hatred gives me power!
Unfortunately, there was a bit of a trade-off.
I lost my partner because of this.
Oh my god, that's awful.
I thought I was going to marry this woman, and she just couldn't handle the amount of attention. She's a very private person.
Yet this was...
That's fucked up, man. God, dude, that's awful, bro. Dude, these people are literally ruining lives. Like, they're ruining lives for a fucking cause that they have no right to get involved with. Like, you could state your opinions, but once you're harassing people, that's just awful. Like, again, I don't mind that people are vegan. If you're vegan, that's totally fine. It's when the ideology infects your life to the point that you think people that aren't vegan are murderers and you harass people in public, like, those people literally need lobotomies, okay? We should bring lobotomies back.
Wasn't the only marriage that Tash's TikToks ruined. Her next target was get...
Honestly, she is fucking worse than Vegan Teacher. Vegan Teacher might have made videos talking about how sucking on the baby's doing shit and all that. Like, that's obviously bad. But this is worse. This is worse. Like, actual real-life consequences to what she's doing. Maybe, I don't think she's as insane as Vegan Teacher, but she is obviously fucking nuts.
This, the Bicton Veterinary Clinic, a business literally designed to help unwell animals, and Vegan Booty lost it over budgies out the front.
You're the type of vets that eat your own patients, are you?
Yeah, I do eat meat, but I don't eat dogs and I don't eat cats and I don't appreciate you pushing your agenda on my personal...
I don't appreciate you enslaving animals.
I have a dog.
This is a vet. How do you go to a vet and blame her for enslaving animals? This is an animal doctor. Like, what is... The animal didn't consent to you curing its cancer. You are stealing its agency.
In a cage out the back at the moment receiving treatment. Am I enslaving it?
Although it seems for the first time ever, Vegan Booty is actually facing consequences.
Good shit. Get annihilated.
Defamation action against Miss Tash Peterson. $17,700 raised. The vet was announcing, "We are launching a civil action in the Supreme Court of Western Australia, which has conveniently been running over the last 2 months. Nice. The trial has revealed that Vegan Booty hasn't only falsified her taxable income.
Oh my god. The court was told that Mrs. Peterson earned more than $400,000. How does she make $400,000 with this vegan grift? Who is supporting her? Bro, OnlyFans is like, it's insane. It's wild. Oh my god, dude. OnlyFans and merch, she made her $400,000. She declared just 70K. Holy shit, annihilator. The fucking IRS is gonna fuck her in the ass.
But she's also been able to ruin another marriage. This might explain why Fi is also suing Tash.
This is gonna teach her a lesson. If she's fined that amount of money, she's gonna think twice.
And while she's always stated,
I actually measure my own success by the amount of haters and criticism that I have.
It seems...
Well, then she just succeeded a little more because I heard of her today.
Penalty after penalty is finally taking its toll. Her public nuisance stunts are becoming far less frequent, as most of her content now focuses on street interviews.
That's right, baby. She's fucking losing it.
Do you have a moral justification for animal abuse?
Yum.
Please say they taste good.
Me.
Yummy! It's as easy as that. Dude, imagine having a TikTok where you do street interviews and it's just a compilation of yourself getting destroyed by people.
Vegan Booty will likely never change, but maybe she's reached a decent middle ground that's respectful not just to animals, but people's lives as well.
Doubt it. Doubt it! She's insane. She needs a lobotomy. That's the Nux diagnosis. I diagnosed Boogie of having fake cancer. I diagnosed Tash Peterson of needing a lobotomy. Thank you for being here. This was annoying. If you are vegan, I love and respect you. If you are vegan that harass people for not being vegans, you are a fucking insane lobotomite. Bye! If you made it to the end, click one of these two videos, which also will definitely get me canceled. See you live on Kink. Stay weird, fam.